my hair. I have no idea what it's doing. So it's looking more and more bad for every minute. Welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to do another episode of me and Paula's shopping our stash collab. Paula is a beauty guru, maybe do it on Instagram and YouTube, and you should definitely check her out if you're not already, but I believe you do. I believe you know who she is. She is amazing. I love her so much. Today we are going to celebrate the month of green, because it was St. Patrick's Day on Sunday, and it is the day that I am filming this. If you're new to this club, this is basically me and Paula shopping our stash for a wanton color of the month, and then just trying to convince ourselves we don't need more of this certain color. And so far we have done it kind of themed, because January was the Pantone color of the year, Living Coral. February was baby pink for Valentine's Day, and here in March it is St. Patrick's Day, which is a very true to color St. Patrick's Day green color. Let's shop our stash for some eyeshadows, some green eyeshadows, and I'm really excited. We are also going to talk about how we're going to make this green shadow work, because not everyone is comfortable about a green shadow. So I'm going to talk about how I make a green shadow work for me. So yeah, and that is basically what I have on my eyes, but I will talk you guys through it as well. But that is going to be in the end of this video. The first one is the most obvious one, because that is my Panda palette for the year. It is the NYX Ultimate Bright palette, and there are greens in this palette, and I'm going to talk about this later in the video as well. So I'm going to swatch that shade right there, because that is, for me at least, a very true to green color, and yeah, I'm going to swatch that one. So this is a matte shade. There are some shimmers in this palette, but most of the time the shimmer does not turn up, which sucks a little bit. But yeah, this is the first green color. Very excited about it. It is very, very pretty. I love using this shade. That's a very lazy swatch, but that is the first color right there. Let me try to build it up a little bit. That was better, right? I need something to take this off. Yeah, I will be right back. The next two I'm going to talk about is from my Blush Tribe Paulina palette, and there are four very, very beautiful greens in this palette, and I'm going to swatch that color right there and that color right there. So that is called Sikke and Humble. Sikke, I believe her dog is called that. It is Swedish, and I'm pretty sure that is how she pronounced it. I forgot mascara on my bottom lashes. I just realized that. That is so stunning. These colors are amazing. So yeah, Humble is definitely more, is lighter than Sikke. So, but they are absolutely beautiful. So that is Humble and that is Sikke. So you can definitely see the undertones in these are definitely different, but I think when you put them on your eyes, they are very true to green color and amazing. The next palette I'm going to swatch from is my Blush Tribe, the Hasina 2 palette. I believe there is a true to green color in the Hasina palette, which is on the way to me, so I will insert a picture from it. But I believe that is a true green as well. I'm not sure, but it is on the way and I will have that. So, yeah, I have one more true to green color. I just realized that. In the Hasina palette, it is looking like this. I'm going to swatch these two right here. This is called Erin and this is called Mahia. Mahia? I don't know. So, they are looking very much alike, the NYX and Sikke or Humble. And one thing these all have in common is they are matte. But the last shadow I'm going to swatch is from my MDK Wise 4 palette. And it is this shade right there, and that is called Grasshopper. It is a beautiful green shimmer. So I'm going to swatch it here. Look at that. So beautiful. I think this is a little bit more teal. It has a more teal undertone, like Sigge from the Paulina palette, but it is, in my eyes, a very true to green St. Patrick Day color. And in real life, it is more green than blue, but it's beautiful. Look at it. Beautiful. I want to swatch that color right there because I have it on my eyelid, and I actually have a Soli, I believe it's called, Soli from the Paulina palette on my lid as well. So in my inner part of the eyelid. So let me swatch those two. This is me dipping into palettes to make this green look workable. I believe I have in my outer corner, or in the middle of my eye slash outer corner, I have Mahia, that color right there, here. And then to deepen up my outer corner, I have Mani, which is a khaki army green. And I like to complement the green eyeshadow and make it a little bit more deeper. It's like deepening, making a shadow in the outer V, so you have a little more depth in the outer corner. Did that make sense? I hope so. So I'm going to swatch these two shimmer blue, no, green. So I'm going to swatch these two shimmer light green shades because I think they are complementing the green shadow, this one right there, Mahia, very, very nicely. I almost always put a shimmery shadow that is matching the outer corner in my inner third of the lid. Look at those. So you can see one is more green and more is more of a teal turquoise blue, but they are matching these kind of colors so well. So I will obviously also use this all over my lid with these in my crease even. But I would, to make a green more wearable, I would definitely put orange together with green, and I think it looks beautiful. I actually have yellow in my inner corner as well. I hope you can see, yeah, here. And then it turns into an orange coral. And I will show you those shades. It's actually 5 in the afternoon, and I think the lighting is very nice. I don't know what that lash is doing, but yeah. Hey, it's okay. So, in my inner corner for the yellow shade, I have these two. Again, it's my Panda palette, but because they are kind of orange in that family, so they match the green really, really well. So, to have a lighter inner corner thing, I have started with the yellow, and then I transition into this coral and rusty shade right here. Orange and green just match so nicely together, and that is my go-to look if I want to do something with green. That is orange. And I actually have dipped into my Morphe 35OM palette because it's all matte. It's very nice to put in my crease, and I use this one a lot, the top shade right there, in my crease out here, and then very packing it on my lower lash line. And again, any of these orangey browns or something like that would match really, really nicely. I think a warmer crease matches a green so, so nicely. Yeah, any of these actually, but I would choose a more warmer toned green and not as much these more blue undertoned greens. Can you even say that? I don't know. So that one from the Hacienda palette was my go-to lid shade, and then I just needed something extra glittery, so I took Soli from the Paulina palette, and this is how it turned out. So the only thing I have not yet to talk about is actually my inner corner, and I had a little bit of a hard time because I usually just put a very bright white shadow in my inner corner, but for this look it just didn't match. So I took my W7 On The Rocks, which is a dupe for the Subculture palette from Anastasia Beverly Hills, and let me tell you, it is an amazing dupe if you don't already know and haven't watched any of my videos. I have taken this shade, which I believe is called Electric from the Subculture palette. This is called Champagne Toast, and I have it in my inner corner. And I think it pairs really, really nicely with the warm crease, and it has a goldenly olive kind of undertone to it, so it matches the green as well. So I just think that ties the look together. I always believe in a highlight or an inner corner highlight or something like that, because it just looks so nice. Yeah, and then I actually put out this palette as well. I don't know why I took out this palette, but I believe it was because of the color scheme of this palette. I'm a little bit confused, if you can tell, but it has a gold and a green, which will pair very nicely with these, because I also think a kind of goldy yellow, again yellow, pairs nicely with a green, and it has some rusty orange tones, and I really like pink with green as well, and even a brown or a more coppery rose gold shade would look so nicely with a matte green, so nicely. So the matte green can be in your outer corner, and you can have something very light on the lid, or you can put a matte green in the crease and then put something rose gold or gold or yellow, or even if you have this kind of coppery shade like that right there, put that all over your lid, and it will look beautiful, and it will make the green so much more wearable. And I think I have rambled on too long, and I think I'm going to end this now, because I think I'm just going to repeat myself, and I want to end this video before the lightning is going to be very bad, and I believe that is soon. I actually like the lightning right now. That is everything for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you got something out of this video. Again, this is Shopping My Stash. It is not perfectly, but I definitely don't need any more greens, because I don't wear them that much. My absolutely go-to look is a goldy brown smoky eye, so this is just a proof that I don't need more green, because you don't really go through these kind of colors that often, because it's not a very go-to, and if you have an office job, it's not always office appropriate to have this much color on. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you haven't already checked out Paula, I would definitely recommend you to it, because she is amazing. She is shopping her style, she is using her products, she has a big collection, and her collection is definitely more different than mine. I don't have as much, and it was actually kind of hard to choose a green color for this video, believe it or not. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, please give it a like, subscribe down below so you don't miss out on the next episode or any other of my videos. I do a lot of padding videos, and I do empties and somewhat fashion related, and if you want me to do more padding looks or something with green and orange, or if you want to see how like in a video how I apply and play with these kind of colors, let me know. Yeah, that was everything for this video, and I will end it now, and until my next video, please take care, and have a good day.